This is day 7 of development of a white leghorn chicken embryo. As you can see, if I rotate the egg, the eye is very recognizable at this stage of development. That is the black or dark spot that continues to emerge as I rotate the egg. Throughout the egg, connecting the embryo to the yolk and albumen or egg white, are red spiderweb looking blood vessels and veins. Those are responsible for absorbing the nutrients from the yolk and albumen throughout the development process of the embryo. The candling light is shown through the air cell of the egg to show a clearer picture. You can see clearly some red spiderweb pattern of blood vessels and veins. Day 7 is a good time to check for fertility in your eggs, as you are able to recognize beginning structures such as the eye. If you wait till later stages, such as like day 14, the embryo will begin to fill the good portion of the egg, and certain structures will be harder to see. This one is a quitter. There is a very recognizable blood ring going throughout the egg. And as you can see on the back side here, the crack could be the reason why this egg can no longer continue to develop, as added bacteria are able to enter the shell when hairline cracks are found on the eggshell. Here we have a yolker. There is no signs of blood vessels or structures developing on the inside of this egg, but you can clearly see the air cell at the top of the end of the egg here, and the yellow spot in the middle is the yolk, and you can see pores covering the outside of the shell, and the clear liquid inside of the egg is the egg white or albumen. This is a quitter. You can identify it by the red blood ring on the outside here. Looks like it made it a few days into development as you rotate it and you see the indication of an eye or the black spot at the middle of the egg. But you can know it's a quitter due to the red blood ring located on the outside of the egg. This is coming off of a mechanical egg turner. If you are doing incubation of eggs by hand, they're most commonly placed on the side, so the embryo would be towards the top end or closer to my flashlight, and the yolk and albumen or egg white would be towards the bottom. And as you rotate the egg, it will naturally move as you rotate the egg when you need to move it 3 times a day. But as it came out of a mechanical turner, the air cell will be facing up, so naturally the embryo is towards the air cell.